Hey, how are you doing? Welcome to Miss Tech Hack. What is this video all about? Let's have a preview. And also welcome to a new short series of Hibernate Basics. Hibernate is a framework that provides the ORM object to relational mapping. The series will cover MySQL installation, operations, and mappings. So if you are new to Hibernate, this series will be very useful to you. Or if you know anyone willing to learn Hibernate Basics, do share and suggest this Hibernate Basics series to them. Today in this video, I will be showing you how to install MySQL in your system. Before we go ahead, make sure to subscribe to Miss Tech Hack, so you don't miss on any of our updates and latest videos. A bonus tip. Are you in a hurry to learn Hibernate? Well, I have a good news for all. Check out the Udemy course link, in description. And you can access all training videos, in just one click. Do watch the video till end, to get all the insights. So let's get started. Step 1, download MySQL installer. Open your browser and go to dev.mysql.com/downloads URL. Click on MySQL Community Server. Select your OS, it is selected as Windows by default. Click on Go to Download page to download the MSI file. Click on Download for Web Community Edition. Click on No Thanks, just start my download. Once the MSI file is downloaded, open in folder. Step 2, install MySQL. Double-click on the MSI file and click on Run. Provide permission by clicking Yes in pop-up. Under Installer, select Custom and click on Next. Click Next. Next, it will show warning that all prerequisites are not downloaded. Click on Yes, it will download all requirements. Click on Execute to download the packages. It will take some time. Click on Execute again to install the downloaded packages. Once downloaded, click on Next, uncheck both options and click on Finish. Step 3, create Eclipse project. Open Eclipse IDE. If you want to know how to set up Eclipse, you can check the video link in description. Provide a path where you want to create the workspace and click on Launch. Expand. Click on File, Project, select Java Project, click on Next, enter project name and click on Finish. If pop-up comes, open in Java perspective. Once project is loaded, add a new folder named as lib. Step 4, download Hibernate ORM jars. Open your browser and visit hibernate.org. Go down and click on Hibernate ORM. Click on Latest Stable Version and click on Download Zip Archive. Soon the download will be started and once downloaded, open in folder and extract files. Once extracted, go inside to lib, required, copy all the jar files and paste to lib folder created in Eclipse. Step 5, download MySQL JDBC driver jar. Again open your browser and go to dev.mysql.com/downloads URL. Click on connector/j, select OS as platform independent and download the zip file. Click on No Thanks. Just start my download. Once the zip file is downloaded, open in folder and extract the files. Copy the MySQL connector Java jar file, and paste to lib folder created in Eclipse. Now, right-click on Project, Properties, Java Build Path, Libraries tab, click on Add Jar, and select all jars in lib to add in build path. Once you click on Apply and Close, you will see references libraries added under your project. Step 6, configure MySQL Server. Open MySQL Installer and reconfigure MySQL Server. Keep the default values and click on Next. Click on Next and provide MySQL password and click Next again. Click on Next and then execute to configure it. Once done, click on Finish and close the installer. Step 7, Run MySQL Scripts. In this step we will basically create a base for operations to be done. Open MySQL Workbench, click on Root Connection and provide your password you set in previous methods. Click on File, Open Scripts. Select the Create New User script provided and run it. Open List of Employees script and run it as well. In the left pane, click on Schemas and refresh so you can see newly created table. And as you can see currently we don't have any data in employee table. Step 8, Test JDBC connection. Let's create a new package. Right-click on SRC, New Package, enter a name and click on Finish. Now create a new class in the package as Test JDBC connection, check public static void main and click on Finish. Now update the main method as shown in video. Add URL, user ID, password, and connection code. Run it as Java application, and as you can see we didn't got any connection error, so connection was successful. So, we have seen how to set up Hibernate prerequisites from scratch. That's it for this video. I hope you find it useful. For any queries or concerns, write me down in the comment section. Thank you so much. Have a great day.